Danny. You owned up to being the father of Carly's baby, and that took a lot of courage.
Well, you're hell-bent on keeping me out of the picture as far as this baby's concerned.
Well, you know, things change.
Bang heads in court over some protracted custody case.
Oh, I don't know. You know what Mom always said, you get more flies with sugar than vinegar.
There is no way I'm sucking up to that witch again.
So are you taking a plane, an ocean liner, what?
All of the above, including elephants and camels.
Excuse me, I don't think so.
Oh, yes, I do think so. See, if we're going to travel the world, we have to be open to all forms of transportation.
Well, that's good, because I'll follow your camel in my Jeep.
Great news. I just wish Lorraine was here to hear it firsthand.
Oh, how's she doing?
She's doing fine, but she's going to have to do a little recuperating.
Can't imagine being hit by a car. My God. And that other major...
Yeah, that tracheotomy, yeah. Well, she just needs to take a little rest. She's having a nap right now. But anyway, we got something to celebrate, right?
That's yes. True to Europe and East Mongolia.
I don't know what I've gotten myself into.
Well, I doubt that I'll be making any stops in East Mongolia on a big tour, but I'm sure that we will cross paths somewhere along the way.
You can count on it.
I think all this good news deserves a toast.
Bring on the bubbly Diana.
Diana.
Yes? You need something over here. Oh, you know it. We need some champagne, doll.
And a bottle of your best apple cider.
With a twist of lime.
Yep.
Got it.
Thank you, Diana.
Hey, where's Buck and Jacob?
Well, my guess is they were waylaid by a last-minute emergency.
Here you go.
According to these statements, none of you saw anything out of the ordinary?
Well, you tell me what's ordinary about seeing your wife holding a baby she just found in a dumpster.
Okay. Look, if you think of anything later, give us a call.
Yeah. That's it?
We're going back to the alley. We'll check for anything we might have missed.
You don't seem too hopeful.
You know, I mean, what are the chances of finding the parents of a kid that was abandoned like this?
Well, we'll be looking, but the odds aren't good.
No sense of a type.
Heart of gold.
Big heart.
How's...
The baby's fine.
A little undernourished, but after a bottle and a good night's sleep, she'll be ready to be turned over to social services.
When?
In the morning, everything works out. Excuse me.
Listen, I better get back to the bar, too.
Kristen, I'll be over in a little bit, okay?
I better go with him.
Thanks for coming along, y'all.
We'll see you.
Appreciate it. I don't know what you're thinking.
So what do you think? Me everything, and you are the last person I want to see right now. Great. So why don't you do us both a favor then and leave? Excuse me. I'm here to see Tony. He's gone. Where? I don't know, Allie. I haven't seen him all day. So, you know, if you don't mind. So fast. It's about the baby.
Yes.
I checked and the nursery is understaffed tonight.
Yeah, a couple of nurses called in sick last minute.
Well, in addition to sleep and feeding, that baby I think is going to need some tender loving care.
We'll call in for a temporary worker.
Well, maybe that won't be necessary. I'm a doctor.
And a mother.
And I was just thinking,
well, actually,
what if...
What we would like to know is if it would be possible to, you know, to hold on to the baby. Just for the night, just for the night.
I sense more than just a sense of duty here.
Well, you know, it couldn't be bad for the baby.
No, But let me ask you a question, and I'd like an honest answer. You forming an attachment to this child?
Yes.
Look, I've no doubt that you mean well, but it's out of the question.
Why?
There are regulations, legal considerations.
Well, what about consideration for the baby? I mean, baby doesn't need red tape. Baby needs tender love and care. It needs to be held.
Yes. I can understand. But the answer's still no. Thank you, Diana.
I gotta be out of my mind doing this.
Well, good luck.
I need more than luck.
Well, it's a little early for the proud papa to be passing out cigars, ain't it?
Nice dress. Going dancing on someone's grave.
Hello, hello, hello.
Hello.
Excuse me, hate to interrupt. Something for you. Severance check.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God, thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Dylan's going to miss you.
Just Dylan?
I'll work on it.
So where are the two of you going to go first?
East Harris. Okay, London.
Well, if it is in fact London, please send Sydney my regards.
I will.
And thank you for the building.
Okay.
See you. Bye. Thank you. Alex Masters, you're dashing as always.
And you are up to no good, as always.
You're just too dense.
What the hell is she up to?
Danny told you, but if you have something to say, Allie, just say it.
You know, there was a time when I would have sworn that nobody could be so incredibly selfish and evil.
Cut the rhetoric and get to the point.
What you and Danny did to me and Tony is unbelievable.
You are pathetic.
What?
Oh, I think that you heard me. You know, Allie, you act like you and Tony are these great lovers of the ages. You know what? You don't deserve a guy like Tony. If you had ever, truly, ever believed in him, I wouldn't have been able to fool him. None of this would have happened.
That's enough.
When I think about how easy you made it for me to break the two of you up.
That's enough,
I mean,
Carla.
I messed up my hair a little bit, and you think we slept together. I put my arm around him. You think that he has his arm around me.
I said that is enough.
Let go of me.
No. Not until we get one thing straight. All of this is your fault. All of it. And you better be thankful you're pregnant, because if you weren't, I'd kill you.
There's the door, Ellie.
I know where the door is. You've gotten everything you deserve. You're pregnant, and you're alone.
Even better, huh?
You're pregnant. And you got him.
Well, I don't suppose you're in the mood for some cake.
But I'm sorry I'm late. Did you find out if Tony and Allie got together?
I don't know. I certainly hope so.
Yeah.
Such a mess.
Yes, that it is. But one thing's for sure, the truth is on the table.
That is for sure.
Speaking of that, what are we having?
How about champagne?
Champagne? What's the occasion?
Yeah, Richard and Zoe got back together. They're going off to see the world. And
really?
Richard invited us over for a toast.
Wow, free champagne? I'm there. Is that you or me?
It's me. Longest, it's Sidney Chase.
Sidney Chase? What the hell is she calling here at this house for?
I have no idea.
Well, let's go find out.
Okay.
So, have you spoken to your dear mom about your trip?
No, I haven't. I was going to, but I thought, well, spoil the surprise.
I suspect old Sid's gonna have a cow when she sees two of you are closer
than
ever.
Can we toast to that?
To Sidney's cow, yes.
Let's just moo to that.
Yes.
Glad to see you guys started without us.
Hey, where's Jake and Angie?
Hey.
They're not back yet. Nick, you are never gonna believe what happened to us.
But I know. Lorraine!
Hey. What are you doing out of bed?
Huh?
How come you should be in bed?
I am fine. I'm fine. Jacob and Angie found a baby. A girl?
Danny, what are you doing here? Haven't you ruined my life enough already?
Look, if you've been beaten up half as much as I have today, you've got to be looking for somebody to be on your side for a change, Carla. Maybe we can reach some kind of an agreement.
I don't want your help, Danny, and I sure as hell don't need your sympathy.
This is not about you and me. It's about our baby, Carla.
What do you suggest that we do? Get married and raise Junior upright?
No. I'm not suggesting we get married. I'm suggesting we take responsibility for this child as adults and raise this child together.
Oh, Danny, I just think...
What?
Oh, my God.
You have any idea what this is all about?
Your guess is as good as mine. That broad's got some nerve showing up here.
If she shows.
She's gonna show.
Hello, boy. Sorry I'm late.
Look, lady, can I help you?
I don't know. Can you?
Prego, che cosa facciamo? Prego, signora.
Thank you, how sweet. Now I just bet. You're all wondering why I asked you here.
I'm assuming this is what you were looking for when you rearranged my late husband's apartment last week.
Where'd you find these?
No. The question should be, what am I planning on doing with them? Now, I'll be the first to admit that I'm no expert in mob dealing.
Yeah, well, you couldn't be to try something like this.
I am assuming that Gino held onto them as a way of protecting himself. Should there be a falling out among his closest friends?
What are you after?
Power. As this gentleman so kindly pointed out, I have been cut off from my family.
So?
I'm in the market for a new family. Capiche?
Can't believe this.
So you just tell the boys. They're looking at the new godmother.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
What is it? Oh, wow. Is it?
That's the baby.
I felt that.
It moved.
Oh, I felt that again.
Oh, man. That's our baby.
Yeah.
No, he probably doesn't like all this yelling.
Maybe. Or maybe she's hungry. What kind of cake did you bring?
Chocolate.
Chocolate? Well, that's our favorite.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think we might be coerced into having a bite or two.
Well, let me get that for you, dear. Do you think she will need a fork?
Yes, dear.
Chase being disposed, you just called me.
If you like, I'd be happy to take a message.
Have we spoken before?
I don't think so.
Look, you know what? You know what? Just tell Sydney to forget it, okay? I have no further business with her, all right?
I have a feeling that won't be a problem. Well, I told you not to try and tell any of my friends in Soho that I'd escaped. Happy now?
Okay, so what should we drink to?
Hey, how about us?
Ooh. Hey, Angie, what do you have there?
Is that a baby?
It sure is.
Isn't she beautiful?
Angie, she's beautiful.
Lorraine, it's because of you that she's alive.
No. She's alive because you believed, Angie.
Well, I know everything's going to be all right now.
You know? No?
You can count on it.
Hey, how about a toast to Cassandra? The newest member of this incredible family.
Yeah. Hey, how about a toast to all of us? It's been a long, rough year.
Boy, you guys have been a long, rough year.
It's a year to remember, y'all.